Hello friends, we welcome you all to this video. In the previous video, we studied the surface area of a cube. Today, in this video, we shall see some interesting examples based on that.
Manas, what are you doing?
Dad has made this new stool for me. I am thinking of painting it. But I can't figure out how many boxes of paint will I need to paint it.
Aha! We can find the solution through mathematics. Do you know what it means?
Absolutely! That means it's math time!
Manas, this tool is cube-shaped. Can you tell me how many square feet can you paint with one color box?
The shopkeeper told me that with one paint box, we can paint an area of 4 square feet.
To find out how many boxes of paint you will need to paint this stool, first we need to find the sum of the areas of all the surfaces of this stool.
But the sum of all the surfaces of this cubic stool will be equal to its total surface area, right?
Absolutely right. Therefore, we will find the total surface area of this cubic stool.
Thomas, this stool is cubic and we wrote this formula for the total surface area of a cube in the formula book of mathematics, where L is the length of the sides of the cube. Now, we just have to write the length of the side of the stool in this formula and we will get its total surface area.
Friends, if the length of each side of the stool is 2 feet, can you find the total surface area of this stool? Pause this video to try it yourself and then come back and match your answer.
The length of each side of the stool is 2 feet. Let me write it here instead of L. Okay, the total surface area of the stool is equal to 24 square feet.
Now, with one box of paint, we can paint an area of 4 square feet. So, if we have to paint the total surface area of the stool, that is 24 square feet, how many boxes of paint will we need? So we have to divide the total surface area of the stool by 4.
Look, Thomas, I got it. 6 boxes of paint are needed to paint the stool. But Thomas, we have only 4 boxes of paint. So what shall we do now?
Don't panic, Manas. Let us paint only the vertical surfaces of this stool. Maybe we can paint these surfaces by using these 4 boxes of paint.
But Thomas, the vertical surfaces of this cubic stool indicate its lateral surface, isn't it? This means that the sum of the areas of these surfaces will be equal to the lateral surface area of this cubical stool.
Friends, can you help Manas find the lateral surface area of this stool? Pause the video to try getting the answer yourself and then match your answer. Do you remember the formula for the lateral surface area of the cube that you learned in the previous video? Let us write 2 feet as the length of the side of the stool instead of L here to find the lateral surface area of the stool. In this way, the lateral surface area of the stool is 16 square feet. With one box, we can paint an area of 4 square feet. So, In order to paint the lateral surface area of the stool, that is 16 square feet, we would need 16 divided by 4, that is 4 boxes of paint.
Look, Manas, you can paint the lateral surfaces of the stool with your 4 paint boxes. Let us return back and paint your stool quickly. Then we have to also go to play.
Both the friends painted the lateral sides of the stool beautifully. In this example, we have seen how we can use the method of finding surface area of the cube in order to solve some problems in our daily lives. In the next video, we shall see some fun concepts based on this.